Hello, everyone. Hello, it's Ria. Thank you for having me. My name is Herbert Yang. I'm the General Manager for Asia from Definity Foundation. Today, I'd like to talk about improving data security and extending interoperability of the Ethereum network. I will share several recent innovations and technical breakthroughs from the ICP ecosystem. So let me first briefly introduce who we are and what we do. Definity Foundation is one of the oldest foundations in crypto, created by our founder and chief scientist, Dominic Williams, in October 2016 in Zurich, Switzerland, as a nonprofit foundation. We are a very research-oriented team and has some of the best cryptographers and computer scientists in our R&D organization, including Jans Gross, who pioneered ZK-SNARK, Jans Kamenesh, our CTO and IEEE fellow, who used to lead IBM's lab in Switzerland, Victor Shoup, who co-authored the famous cryptography textbook with Dan Bonet, and Ben Lin, the L in the BLS algorithm. So with that introduction, let me dive into today's topics. I will share four technical breakthroughs in recent months from the developers in the ICP ecosystem. They tackle four important questions for crypto. How to get data from Web2 without using Oracle? How to store private data in smart contract? How to sign transactions on any blockchain without breach? And what about another vertical roll-up solution for Ethereum that's fast and cost-efficient? So before we go deeper, let me take one step back to give you some context so that you can connect some dots in the following slides. For developer, what's the difference between developing on ICP versus developing on Ethereum in broad strokes? To build a fully-fledged web application, a developer needs to write Solidity smart contract that's executed in EVM and runs on the Ethereum network, host the front end somewhere open on Amazon Web Services, and store the data somewhere on services such as IPFS. For ICP, we call our smart contract Canister, which is lightweighted Docker with stable memory up to 100 gigabyte memory that can do three things in one: decentralized ledger, computation, and data storage. Canister can be of any type of web service, from a DeFi protocol, an NFT smart contract, a DAO proposal, steady website, or just a good old-fashioned software as a service product, or just online game. So another important concept is subnet. ICP handles horizontal scaling by using subnet, which often consists of 13 replicas or known machines. The number based on the required level of security can be adjusted up or down. It's a balance between security and performance. With that out of our way, let's talk about the first issue, how to fetch data from Web2. The majority of world's data is hosted on Web2 services that's out of reach for blockchains. Blockchains are isolated islands that just cannot pull in data or push out data to any external system. This is one reason that makes smart contract deterministic. They execute exactly as they are written with much higher level of certainty than traditional system. But this is also a major showstopper for crypto to achieve mass adoption. The current industry solution is to use Oracle. Off-chain Oracle providers read from data source and write to a dedicated smart contract on Ethereum. Other smart contract can then read this data by requesting to the Chainlink contract on Ethereum. This method, very popular, has a few downsides. It requires off-chain infrastructure that defeats the purpose of online decentralization. You have to trust the third party that may or may not have malicious intent. It introduces additional point of failure and could be costly for use cases that are not widely used. So Definity's R&D team introduced a feature called HTTP outcalls a few months ago that will enable Canister smart contract to request a URL so that the Canister can directly obtain off-chain data or interact with an off-chain system such as a typical Web2 service or just enterprise IT infrastructure. This is how it works. Let's say a Canister smart contract needs to fetch Bitcoin price from Coinbase. It requests an outcall. Every node in the subnet makes an HTTP request to the target server on Coinbase and receives a response. Each node then locally processes the result. When the nodes on this subnet are able to reach consensus on what the response to the request should be, they include it as a special type of payload in an IC block. Once this block is finalized, it's passed on to the execution layer, which will deliver the HTTP response back to the original canister. The canister can then resume the original smart contract call and safely use the HTTP response to change its state without risking divergence across replicas. So essentially, HTTP outcalls can do what blockchain oracles are doing now. And what you will get as a developer is a higher level of trust. Your choice is between trusting a decentralized layer one blockchain network versus trusting an independent Oracle entity. You'll also get out-of-box solution from HTTP outcalls and don't have to make a series of complex decisions, say choosing between a single or multiple oracles and how to reduce cost and speed up the request. For the end users, they will get cheaper service in the end because the Oracle middleman is no longer needed when smart contracts begin to use HTTP outcalls functionality. So overall, the canister HTTP outcalls feature allows us to achieve what oracles do, but in a much more robust model, in a much more decentralized fashion. So moving on to the second issue, confidentiality is a major problem for blockchain. It's even worse than what we got in Web 2. A lot of clear text data are transmitted on many servers or even on public blockchains. There are several industry solutions at the moment. One is trusted execution platforms such as AMD's SEV SMP or Intel's SGX to ensure that even node operators won't be able to see what's inside the node machines they own. But they have poor record. Track record against adversaries with physical access, so it remains to be seen how effective this method is. Alternatively, you can also share the secret, but it doesn't scale very well. Another popular method is to do a zero knowledge or MPC, but it only works for limited functionality on Zcash and Monero, not so much for general execution. The last one is to use encryption key management by users, but this one lacks hardware support and often relies on web browsers for storage, which is insecure and inconvenient, and it has a rather appalling user experience when users want to synchronize across multiple devices. So with traditional public key encryption, each user has his own public and private key pair. For Bob to send an encrypted message to Alice, Bob needs a public key of Alice. Saving your private key securely has become the holy grail for crypto. But is that the only way? Not necessarily. Just last month, the engineers in Definity's R&D team developed a solution that can save private data in a canister smart contract and no longer need key pair. It's called verifiable encrypted threshold keys, or just VEC keys in short. VEC keys leverages identity-based encryption, or IBE. So with IBE, users don't need to generate separate key pairs. They can just use their identity, like an ID number or just email address, as their public key. IBE will encrypt the file using a master public key together with the user's ID. Users can encrypt files using their ID and decrypt files using the decryption key derived from the private key generator, or PKG. Through the PKG's master key, a unique decryption key can be computed for every ID. So with IBE, user just needs to hold on to one master public key. This makes key management much simpler. However, there is a catch. IBE relies on a trusted third party, a private key generator, to generate the master key pair. So IBE actually knows everyone's decryption key. If this PKG is compromised, all user data is lost. So that's not gonna work for us. So Definity team came up with a distributed key derivation scheme called VEC keys. VEC key uses the nodes on ICP subnet to replace the private key generator in identity-based encryption. As the chart illustrates, multiple nodes will jointly generate the master key. No individual node knows the final key. There's no single point of failure. Even if some nodes are compromised, the actual private key will not be directly revealed. Compared to traditional schemes, VEC keys does not rely on a trusted execution environment and has a higher security level. Users can encrypt private data. Nodes will collaborate to decrypt the key and send it to the user without revealing the actual key in the process. Moreover, a single subnet public key can derive unlimited separate identity keys. This unlocks a whole new paradigm on blockchain that's never seen before in the history of the internet. It means we can now finally have real end-to-end encryption for many web applications such as private chat and private payment. There are many interesting use cases for VATKeys. Really, you are only limited by your creativity. End-to-end encryption of messages and data storage are the two obvious cases with massive market potential. Some food for other thoughts. Diamond switch, how about for journalists, dissidents, and whistleblowers? They can now reveal secret or sensitive content to collaborators at a predetermined time and date. How about digital inheritance to pass down digital assets and write a canister smart contract as your digital will? How about encrypting messages to the future, on a predetermined time and date? And how about swapping assets across blockchains for DeFi using VATKeys as signature by the decentralized app instead of implementing another Lite client? How about secret bidding auctions to prevent the MEV or the miner extracted value, which has cost the industry at least $600 million since 2020. There are many more ideas. Again, this is the whole new world waiting for you to discover. So please do check out the documentation on the link and try out VATKeys for yourself. The third issue we want to tackle today is integrating multiple blockchains. We live in a multi-chain world, but the blockchains don't talk to each other that much. If they do, the communication is not very secure. Current DeFi solutions are too blockchain dependent or very homogeneous. They offer very little interoperability, and almost all of them rely on centralized bridges. And all the centralized bridges that involve human will be compromised in the end. It's not a question of if, but more of a matter of when. So the solution from the Divinity team to solve this cross-chain integration issue is to use threshold ECDSA to sign everything. Let's use the Bitcoin network as an example. If we want to integrate with Bitcoin, that means canister smart contract needs to talk to the Bitcoin mainnet. The key challenge is that Bitcoin network will only accept signed transactions. Smart contract cannot hold private key because it will be replicated over many different node machines. So what we need is an ECDSA signing service that can give a public key to the smart contract and sign a message for this smart contract so that the smart contract can now talk to the Bitcoin network. Under the hood, the nodes jointly run the secure multi-party computation protocol to sign the message. No single node knows anything about the secret signing key. Therefore, no single node or even a small minority can forge a signature. So far, this is very classy from the 80s cryptography. So not exactly anything new. In order for this to work in blockchain today, with the performance that we need, we need some additional requirements, such as tolerating malicious nodes of maybe up to one-third, assuming that asynchronous communication at some nodes could be going down and because of DOS attack and won't always be online at the same time as the internet as today is just very unstable. And also, we need to guarantee output delivery to make sure a signature can be generated fast and deterministically in the end. That's not always easy. So this one page really won't do justice to explain how threshold ECDSA works. Our principal researcher, Yang Groves, recently had a China roadshow and did quite a few academic talks for the top researchers and cryptographers in China to explain the whole threshold ECDSA at several top universities. So please do check out our Twitter for the link to the video for a more detailed walkthrough. So threshold ECDSA is a foundation protocol that makes it possible to have direct integration with just any blockchain, from Bitcoin to Ethereum. We no longer need to have decentralized or centralized bridge and place blind trust in the third party. Canister smart contracts on IC can send messages that is signed by the ECDSA service, which runs on ICP, that will be recognized and accepted by Bitcoin mainnet. Essentially, this means Bitcoin can now have smart contract capabilities. Bob can write a canister smart contract that says, set up a recurring payment schedule to send 0.1 BTC to 100 wallet addresses every month for the next 6 months. That is not possible. with the direct integration of BTC and ICP. And Definity team is now working with developers in the community to work on direct integration between ICP and Ethereum. Once this feature becomes available in the coming months, smart contracts on ICP and Ethereum can make API calls to each other and achieve true cross-chain interoperability. ICP will have the potential of becoming another very viable layer 2 on Ethereum. Which begs the next and last question. How do we do that exactly? I mean, for ICP to join the EVM family. EVM is already a big family with many blockchains. Currently, a canister smart contract is not compatible to EVM, and this creates a considerable barrier for Solidity developers to use ICP and leverage ICP's unique features. For example, no dependency on centralized clouds, as canister can host front-end of web applications. Low latency for crucial data, as ICP's update calls can achieve 1 to 2 seconds finality. ICP can also reduce friction for end users, as its unique DID solution, Internet Identity, uses biometric authentication method that's already familiar to billions of mainstream users. So we have an intermediary solution now that is called EVMC, or EVM on IC, that is developed by the Definity team. Definity is one of the most experienced developer studios in the IC ecosystem. That has been building on ICP since our mainnet genesis 2 years ago. So a few months ago, it successfully deployed EVM on the IC canisters. It consists of 4 components. The EVM API canisters serve as the entry points to the system, where they receive requests from Ethereum clients and internet computer agents. Once received, those requests are batched into a pending transaction pool. Then the EVM executed canister will process these transactions, update the global EVM state and the blockchain canister accordingly. The blockchain canister itself is the structure that contains the Ethereum chain blocks. It persists in the internet computer stable canister storage, which has a current size limit per canister of 48 gigabytes. There are plans now by the Definity team to expand the state storage to 1 terabyte in the coming year, which would then allow EVMC to persist the entire Ethereum blockchain data in a single canister. Next, the signature verifier canisters are used to verify the signature of an Ethereum transaction, which is a very computationally expensive task that is performed in a dedicated pool of canisters to avoid too much overhead in the EVM API canisters. So what can you do now with EVMC? You can now deploy another Ethereum Layer 2 network that's faster and cheaper, entirely on the IC canisters, without the trouble of setting up its own network of Layer 2 nodes, because that part is already taken care of by the ICP network. So try it out. There are other innovative features from ICP that could be interesting for developers, but we won't have the time today to cover all of them, such as hosting front-end of your web applications, reverse gas fee that lowers the onboarding cost for your users, service nervous system, what we call a SNS, that can decouple the ownership of the decentralized app from the founders to achieve true, shall we say, immortality. And also internet identity mentioned earlier that can reduce security risk from centralized browsers. So let's recap. There are unique strengths from Ethereum and ICP ecosystems in several areas. Recent breakthroughs in ICP such as HTTP outcalls, VACs, threshold ECDSA, and EVM on IC can really help Ethereum to have higher data security and improve cross-chain interoperability. So putting these strengths together, maybe, just maybe, we can have world computer at last. Last but not the least, it's great to have this opportunity to share these exciting technology innovations from ICP to the developer community at ETH Riyadh. This is where you can touch base with us, and we want to invite all the Solidity developers to explore what we can do together. Thank you very much for your time.